Hi Scorpio, welcome back to Omkara Tarot and to your Love Bite, which is a bit delayed, I'm sorry. You know, holidays, house guests, but better late than never, right? So here it is. I hope there's a message for you. And these are, of course, general collective readings, Scorpio. Will not resonate with all of you. Please keep that in mind. Take what works for you and leave the rest. So let's begin. Oh, Queen of Swords, upright. The Emperor in reverse, the Moon in reverse, the Fool in reverse, Seven of Pentacles in reverse, Judgment in reverse, Knight of Swords in reverse, Star in reverse, and then the Death card. Okay, so the only upright, two upright cards, and bottom of my deck I have the Eight of Cups as well. Somebody's walking away. Somebody's walking away from an Emperor who's being very stubborn here. I think this Queen of Swords has her boundaries up and saying, hey, if you're going to be stubborn, if you're not going to offer me anything substantial and not put in any investment, I'm not giving you a second chance here. If you're going to be immature and be rash, or not just rash, but this is immature behavior, I would feel. Somebody feels, well, then I'm losing hope in you. You're just being stubborn. Right? So this Queen of Swords is the person, I think, who's bringing some kind of transformation, either ending it completely, or maybe there's a transformation coming. I have no clue. But the impression I'm getting, Scorpio, at the moment, no investment. Well, the Queen of Swords says, I'm walking away. I want somebody who's going to be there for me in the long run. I'm looking for somebody who's going to be stable in my life. I want somebody who's going to show up, you know, for me. And well, if you're not going to be that person, I'm not really crying over you either. I have my sword up, my boundary up, and I'm going to walk away from you. All right, so that's just the first look. But of course, I'll clarify all these cards for you, Scorpio. Let's start with some dialogue message cards and see if you guys could say something to each other, what that would be first, okay? So Scorpio and that person, Spirit, if they could say something to each other now, what would that be? Scorpio and that person, thank you. A few more from here, Scorpio. Scorpio and that person. Scorpio and that person. And if any of you are looking for personal reading, Scorpio, my email is in the description box below. You can reach me there. Scorpio and that person. Alright, Scorpio, your first card here says, you're all I think about. The past, the good times, our crazy passion, the drama, and how I want you now. Damn. Okay, so I think this Emperor is the one who enjoys the drama. Maybe they're just being stubborn or manipulative, or they just want things to go their own way. But what they don't realize is that, well, this Queen of Swords is not going to play these games. They'll just quietly pick up their sword and either cut off this person or just walk away from them. Okay. Next card says, I know that you're with someone else, but you could tell me the truth about how you feel so I don't think I'm going effing crazy. So either this Emperor feels that this Queen of Pentacles already has somebody and that's why they're behaving like this. Or maybe this Queen of Swords feels the reason why this Emperor is not taking action towards them is because, yes, they must be fooling around elsewhere. It drives me crazy when you behave like a spoiled child who takes my love for granted. Yes, I love you unconditionally, but I'm not your parent. And quite frankly, your behavior takes the piss at times. You need to act like an adult for our relationship to work. Said by the Queen of Swords, I feel. They're saying, what is this immature behavior, controlling behavior, stubborn behavior, right? Foolish behavior. Either you man up or woman up and, you know, meet me halfway or forget it. I'm not just going to be there for you like a parent. I'm silent due to going through the dark night of the soul. I feel like an emotional roller coaster and don't have the strength to communicate with you right now. Maybe they don't feel like an emperor. I don't know. Maybe this person doesn't feel strong enough or emperor enough to face this Queen of Swords. That could be their side. Let's see. I'll clarify it and find out. You were in my dreams again last night. I always dream of you every night. You are my ultimate fantasy. My heart breaks a little more every day that we are apart. I'm very curious to see what this death card means in the end. Is it going to transform into a new beginning or is it going to end? Please make time for me. Let's talk and clear the air. All right, so these were some of your messages, Scorpio. If these were resonating, let's start with an angel blessing card. Let's see what my angels have for you first. Blessing, guidance, advice, or a message for Scorpio. Scorpio. Blessing, guidance, advice, or a message for Scorpio. And the card I get for you, Scorpio, is reward. I don't know what this means for you. This is, who else got this? I think Pisces? I'm not sure. One of these zodiacs, I just did got this one as well. So either, yes, you're going to be rewarded for keeping your boundaries up. If you're this Queen of Swords, maybe you have learned to take care of yourself and have your boundaries in place and not let other people take advantage of you or fool you. Well, your rewards are coming in one way or the other, and maybe it's time to reward yourself as well. If this Emperor is not taking any action, maybe they're not worth it. You walk away and you reward yourself. And that's when the universe turns around and says, hey, this one has a lot of self-respect. We should send this person somebody really good, which matches their vibration. Okay. So, Queen of Swords sitting here with this nice shiny sword. I'm going to give her the mic, Scorpio. Let's see what she wants to say to us, okay? So, Queen of Swords, say something to us. Queen of Swords. Queen of Swords says, I didn't really want to end things with this Emperor, but I expected them to come towards me, right? I really thought we could go forward, but right now I'm feeling, this is not going to work. I don't feel that connection anymore. Why is that, Queen of Swords? Why do you feel this way? Why do you feel this way? Because this Queen of Swords was waiting for an Emperor. They were waiting for an actual Emperor in the upright. They wanted somebody to come and take charge of a connection, not be a child and be treated like, you know, somebody who has to be taken care of. I think this Queen of Swords, I think, waited for this person to come up and do the right thing. There was a lot of waiting, I think, by this Queen of Swords, and by the end of it, I think they started to feel, well, this person is not behaving the way I want them to behave, maybe felt a bit abandoned, maybe felt a bit left out in the cold, and realized that this can't be the perfect match for me. I think I'd rather, keep it moving and shaking and moving forward, leaving all these eight empty cups behind. This person is too stubborn, is not an Emperor, but an Emperor in reverse. I think this Queen of Swords is the one. Yes, this Queen of Swords saying, hey, listen, I'm dropping this. I'm not stopping for nobody. Yes, I've checked them out and they didn't behave properly. I gave them an ample opportunity to do the right thing, but I'm not wasting time for any fools here. I'm dropping them. And I know I'm worth it. I'm going to keep it moving and shaking until I, find my perfect match. The Moon in reverse, Spirit. Moon in reverse. Something got revealed here. What got revealed? Something came to an end. Yes, maybe this Queen of Swords who's now again showed up, Scorpio, but now in reverse, right? So I think something came out in the open. It forced this Queen of Swords to get even more distrustful, maybe a little more angry, a little more disappointed. And that's the reason this Queen of Swords has decided, I think it's best to shut this chapter down before it even begins. What's the Fool in reverse, Spirit? Fool in reverse. Now somebody is feeling very foolish. Somebody is feeling very, very foolish. They do want now to communicate. Now they feel they made a very foolish mistake. Now they do want to clear the air. They do want to talk. They don't know how to do it, feeling very, very miserable. Earlier, maybe this person was sitting in a bit of a greedy energy. Well, I don't want to change. I'm the emperor in reverse. I have control issues. I like my life the way it is. I don't want to change things in my life. But now they're feeling deeply unhappy because all those other options, well, nothing is really working, feeling very bored and lonely and sad. Now feeling really bad that they wasted time and never invested when the time was right. Seven of Pentacles in reverse, and they kind of destroyed this connection. They're feeling very, very depleted, devastated that why didn't I invest when the time was right. And now they feel, well, I'm not going to get a second chance now. This Queen of Swords has given up on me. They've judged me, and now I'm not going to get a second chance with this Queen of Swords. Judgment spirit in reverse. Judgment in reverse. Okay. They were sitting in a bit of ego and pride at that point, Scorpio. This person probably came across as a bit of a player, and I know I have so many people around me. I'm not interested in a connection. Something, there was some immature behavior that this person could have displayed, and they are now feeling, oh, what did I do? Now I'm not going to be forgiven or given another opportunity to be with this Queen of Swords. So Knight of Swords in reverse spirit. Knight of Swords. Somebody is very frustrated. They went the wrong direction. They're feeling hopeless. They're feeling stuck. And why? Because they feel this Queen of Swords has now completely turned her back on them. And they feel now their wish is not going to come true. They feel this Queen of Swords is now holding back from them. They are contemplating coming forward with a bit of an apology. They really want this happiness back in their life. They really do want to come and offer maybe an apology or a sweet hello or a love offer or something. So that's why I said I was intrigued to see what this death card would bring for you in the end. Is it going to transform the connection, or is it really the end? So what's the death card, spirit? What's the death card here? Death card. Okay. One more. Somebody really does want to talk. The only problem is that they are not sure whether this reunion is possible after all that mess that's happened. Maybe this imbalance in this connection now. They're sitting in a lot of passion for this Queen of Swords now, but unable to say anything. They're unable to send that message or talk. As much as they want this partnership desperately and want to get out of this feeling of, loss, I don't think they have the guts to actually say something. So they're standing quietly and spying. They're watching from afar, maybe watching this Queen of Swords on social media or something, or finding information. Will they ever come forward, spirit? Will this person ever come forward? I'm not sure, Scorpio, because it seems that this Queen of Swords means business. This Queen of Swords came out first, came out again in the reverse, and now is showing up as the Queen of Cups in reverse. I think this Queen of Cups is the one who's putting an end to this, expecting this person to even come back. This Queen of Swords is very strong. This Queen of Swords is not going to sit around and cry or have sleepless nights over somebody. It's like, hey, listen, if you have competition, keep the competition. I'm not going to be part of it. I think this Queen of Swords is the one who's feeling, I have no love to give you anymore, and I'm not stressing about it either. If it's ended, so be it. I'm happy moving forward. I know my worth. I know what I deserve. Maybe there's a brand new beginning coming for this Queen of Swords with somebody. Yes, there is. Somebody is coming quickly. Somebody who is going to be an equal match for this Queen of Swords. Samdhi, why? Because I think they kept their self-respect, they kept their pride, they kept their boundaries up. They are going to be rewarded by somebody who's going to come forward and do the right thing. Yes, it's going to be a brand new chapter with the perfect partner for this Queen of Swords. All right, so that's what I have for you. Till next time then, love and light. Take care. Namaste, Scorpio.